Hey everyone, this is Cory again with the Yosemite Conservancy, and I wanted to come to you today with a little naturalist nugget. And this is something you can do actually in your backyard. You can explore in your backyard or even looking out the window from your apartment. You might be able to find some of these growing. And this is something I get asked about a lot here in Yosemite. People will come to Yosemite, people will be walking around the valley floor, and you'll look up at these big granite walls, and you'll see black streaks coming down the granite walls. And people will often ask, you know, what are those black streaks? I don't see any water in that area. What is that? And what they are is actually lichen. And you'll find lichen all throughout the world. And what lichen is a symbiotic relationship between fungus and algae. And if we come a little bit closer here, there's some lichen on this rock here in my backyard. And if we look closely, we can find all sorts of different lichens growing just on this rock. There's some sort of grayish coloration of lichen here, some greens, maybe even a little bit of orange. It's really beautiful when you look at it. So lichen, as I said, is a symbiotic relationship between fungus and algae. A great way to remember it is Freddy the fungus and Annie the algae took a lichen to each other. So the fungus provides the home and the algae provides the food. And when scientists started looking at lichens, they actually had to come up with a new word for the relationship that they have. And so in the 1800s, that's when we came up with the word symbiotic. Yeah, in fact, the word symbiotic was created just to describe the relationship with lichens between fungus and algae. And we're still learning more about lichens today. In fact, we just learned recently that that it's actually two fungi and one algae that make up a lichen. For years, we thought it was just a relationship between one fungi and one algae. Today, we understand it's a relationship between two fungi and an algae. So go out in your backyard, look around. If you can find some lichen, or maybe look out the window and see maybe on the sides of buildings if you can find some lichens. And if you do, that's a great indicator of air quality. Lichens are indicators of clean air. So if you find some lichen, take a big deep breath. Because you have nice clean air where you live.